there is one other exercise on the floor. It's called the McKenzie push-up. McKenzie was a very, very good physiotherapist, and he came up with a series of exercises for back pain. A lot of theories with back pain are that your tummy muscles aren't strong enough. Then there's also a lot of theories that your back muscles aren't strong enough. And most of the time, I think it's back muscles aren't strong enough. Now, McKenzie came up with just a series of exercises. One is just sort of doing a push-up, but trying to use your back muscles to help you. So you're using your back muscles and then pushing up, holding it for a second, and then down. If that's really difficult, just do it on your elbows. And down, and then up. And as you get better, you can go up like that. And repeat that 10 times. There are some other things you can do to really help your back muscles get a lot stronger from this position. Just quite simply, just trying to lift up your arms and your legs and make it harder like this. Or you can even do the lifting up opposite arm and leg like so. And if you're really, really strong, and again, most people should be able to do this because you could do this when you're a kid. This is like the squatting thing again. Most kids can do this, but most adults seem to lose the ability to do it, which is a bridge. And your neck should be strong enough for you to be able to hold this position without really any strain. But don't try this first. You want to use your arms, and then of course there's the pushing up into the crab position. But you should be able to hold this position for about 3 minutes without any real strain, if your spine is as strong as it should be. And if you can do this for 3 minutes, then you'll probably never get back there again. With the bridge, again, it's actually fantastic to start with the gym ball to make sure you're not going to hurt or injure yourself. You just lean back, make sure your whole spine is in contact with the gym ball, and you just slowly stretch over it. Now, it depends on how tall you are as to the size of gym ball you need. But even just trying to get stretched out like this on it is really good to start off with. And you just slowly get more and more stretchy. And then you can try and almost push yourself off of it as well. Now, as it gets a little bit easier, I'll just get rid of this one and we're gonna have a smaller one. If you want to use a little bit more strength, again, use a smaller gym ball or deflate the one you've got, then you'll find that it's a little bit easier to get all the way over, so you can get your head on one side and your feet on the other, and then you can sort of push up a little bit from there. And as you get used to it, you can then just get rid of the gym ball altogether. Now, I won't do it on hard surface because it does hurt the head.